Hello guys, and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amuls Academy. So today in this tutorial we are discussing about the assignment operator, deep copy and shallow copy. But if I cover these three topics in a single video, it will become very lengthy. So that's why I divided this video into three parts. So this will be part 1, so this will be part 2, so this will be part 3. So today in this tutorial we are discussing about the assignment operator. Next, in the next tutorial we'll discuss about the shallow copy, and next to next tutorial we'll discuss about the deep copy. Okay, so let's begin with the basics. First of all, why I want to copy any data? Because if I want to store the original data as well as if I want to modify the same data, then I need a copy of that, right? So that's nothing but if this is my data, okay? So I want to modify it, but I want to save this original data also. Then I can copy it, okay? So this is the copy of that data. Okay, so now both this data contains same content. So now I can do any modification here. Okay, so in that way I can do a modification on the data as well as I can save the original data also, right? This is the purpose of copying. Okay, so now in Python we can use assignment operator to copy the data. So for example, here I'll take x equal to 4. Okay, so now I'll take another variable and I'll assign the value of x to this. Okay, so here the x value is 4. After this, y value is also same. Okay, now I can do any modification on this variable. So here we are altering x, but original value is safe in y, right? But here this assignment operator is not copying the data. This y is the another name given to this value 4. So when I take x equal to 4, that is nothing but if this is the value 4, this is the x, the name given to that value. Okay, when I take y equal to x, that is nothing but y will be the another name given to this value 4. Okay, so id of x and y will be same. Okay, it contains same id. So this assignment operator won't copy the data, it will give another name to the data, but it will fulfill the purpose of copying, right? So it allows us to save the original data as well as it allows us to modify the data also. Okay, so now you may ask, this assignment operator may not be copy the data, but it will fulfill the purpose of copying. So then what is the need of this shallow copy and deep copy? Why we need to use this? So we need shallow copy and deep copy because this assignment operator will work for the immutable objects. Here we took the value 4, this is a constant. So this assignment operator will work for the immutable objects. But when I take mutable objects like list, set, dictionary, it won't work properly. It will behave differently. Here immutable object is nothing but object which cannot be altered. Mutable is nothing but objects which can be altered. Okay? So list, set, dictionary, these are all the mutable objects. When I apply this assignment operator on them, it will behave differently. I will show an example. So here I'll take a list. Fine. Now I'll take list 2, assignment operator list 1. Okay. So now if I print list 2, it will contain the same set of data. But as I said, lists are the mutable objects, so I can alter them. So now if I do any changes to list 2 or list 1, it will affect both. I will show you that. So here I'll take list 2 and I'll append a new value to this, okay, like 10. So now if I check list 2, it contains the new value, okay, that's fine. But if I check list 1, this also contains a new value, that is 10. So when I alter one list, it will affect the another list also. So that is because, as I said, when I take list 2 equal to list 1, Okay, so here this is the list one. Okay, so it will contain the reference to the values. It won't contain the values, it will contain the reference. So it is like this. It will be one. Okay, so when I take list two equal to list one, so that time this is the another name given to this, right? So list one and list two ID will be same. So next, if I do any changes like list two dot append 10, okay, so it will add, it will create a new object and that reference will be stored here. Okay, so because both these names are referring the same value, changes will affect both the list. Okay, so I'll show you that. Here if I check ID of list 1 is equal to ID of list 2, yes, it is true. Both these names are referring the same value. That's why if I do any changes in one list, it will affect the another. So it won't satisfy the copying purpose, right? Our copying purpose was to save the original data and do modification on the copied data. But here, if I do the modification on the copied list, it will affect the original list also. Okay, so that's where this shallow copy and deep copy are useful. In these cases, we can use shallow copy or deep copy. Okay, to know about the shallow copy, you need to watch the next tutorial. So I'll stop the part one here. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.